Hi everyone and welcome back. So in previous video we were talking about validating the expression, right? We were just checking if this expression is balanced or not using stack. So there are different ways. The first way we talked about is first find out the index of opening bracket, any kind of opening bracket, and that can be only possible if the modulus of that index is 0. Then we'll just push it and we'll push the index plus 1. The reason behind this pushing the index plus 1 is if the next element is coming, okay? So if the next element is coming as a closing bracket, then we would be able to see if whenever we are doing a stack pop is equal to that bracket index. I mean, this is expected that whenever you are doing a stack dot pop should be equal to the index of the next closing bracket, because we already pushed plus 1 index. So whatever is in the stack at the topmost should be equal to the index of any closing bracket which is coming now, right? Otherwise this return false, and finally stack of length should be equal to zero. Then another case is we had a beginner brackets array or ending brackets array, square bracket, closing bracket and all, and then for every character we are just checking this condition, if this is index of not equal to minus 1, if this is a opening bracket, push it to the stack, and if this is a closing bracket, first check the length of array. If it is already 0, it means expression is not valid. Otherwise find out the index of it, and for the same index try to find out what is the beginner element and check whenever you are doing a pop, because we pushed only the opening elements, right? So for the same index we will check, okay, for this closing bracket this is the opening value, right? So for the same ender's index we are getting the beginner value and we are comparing, both should be equals, that should be fine, otherwise return false. So on the similar lines we can also just write another set of code which is doing, we have a stack, we are iterating onto the string, first we are getting the character, character one by one, and we are checking if these characters belongs to the opening brackets, push that into the stack. If this belongs to the closing bracket, this one square bracket closing, then we will check if stack is not empty. First of all, if stack is empty, we are just checking the negative cases. If stack is empty, obviously we will return false in all the cases, but if stack has element, then whatever you are doing pop should always be equal to this opening bracket, right? Because we are now encountering closing square bracket, so whenever you do the pop it should be opening square bracket, otherwise return false. So we just covered the negative conditions for all. If this is the square bracket, closing brackets, then like this. So there are three different ways we did. So whatever the way you wanted to choose, you can do. All are using stack as a data structure. We are doing push and then we are doing pop, and when we are doing pop we are just checking that the popped element should be equal to the closing bracket of that, because if the square bracket is opening and if you are doing pop the square bracket opening, then the next character should be a closing square bracket, okay? So in the next videos we have now have a quick tricky questions which are as simple as a string reversal from different ways. Either you can just do a string dot split dot reverse dot join, you iterate onto the string characters, you push all the strings into the stack, and then you pop and join all the characters. So all these possible combinations we will talk about. We'll talk about finding out the max three elements from the array. So there is, and splitting the array into the number of chunks. You have given an array and you have given the input 3, so you have to split the array into 3 equal chunks if possible, right? So these kind of set of questions we are going to do in the coming set of videos, okay? Thanks everyone.